As MP for West Belfast and as Sinn Féin have held the seat for such a long time, do you think that it is good enough that West Belfast has the second highest rates of child poverty in the UK? What have you and what has your party have done and what will you do?
Well, we've done a lot on that particular issue, and I think one of the best combatants of child poverty and other poverty is giving people jobs, and I think that's what we've worked very hard to do. Over the last 12 months alone, the unemployment rate in West Belfast has fallen by over 900 people. We were number one in the north of Ireland. We're no longer number one, so we're moving in the right direction, albeit far too slow for my liking. But we are working very hard to create employment opportunities which will give people a chance in life, which will allow them to feed their children, which will allow them to put clothes on their children's back and allow them to give a good education to their kids. So you're not going to fix any of these problems in a very short period. These are all long-term solutions, but it's something that we're working very hard to do. This constituency in West Belfast was disenfranchised for decades under British direct rule ministers. You can't turn that, just overturn it overnight. So we're working very hard, and I think we're going in the right direction. The fact is that the unemployment rate has come down. I see some of our schools, we're trying to get investment into our schools. We have new schools across West Belfast, and we have more to come.
How can you claim to represent the people of West Belfast if you do not take your seat? Don't you think that not taking your seat is outdated? Many young people don't see the point anymore.
I don't think, and I can't remember a vote ever taking place in Westminster that made a difference to here in the north of Ireland. So we would tell you that outside the chamber is when you get more work done, because I have more time because I'm not maybe sitting for a number of hours every day in a chamber in Westminster where it has no relevance to here whatsoever. I mean, I can be robbing doors of different government departments, different parties, and the lobbying to work for the people of West Belfast. So I think you actually get more value for money, even though Westminster MPs for Sinn Féin, they don't get a salary from Westminster. Our party gives us the industrial wage. So, but I think it's much more value for money when you don't take your seat in Westminster, and I think is that we can have that bit of freedom to go and lobby more. I've seen people in Westminster, I'm sure you've seen it yourself, is that you see many of the MPs in Westminster landsleeping during some of the debates. I don't want to be landsleeping through any debate. I want to be making sure that I'm delivering for this constituency and that I'm working hard for the constituents.
How can we foster good relations between Catholics and Protestants when all people see are Sinn Féin and the UP fighting?
Well, you have to find out what the arguments are for. I mean, I think we are a very open party. I think we have made massive strides in many over recent years. You've seen where Martin McGuinness, for example, shook hands with the British Queen, where we have worked with party colleagues right across this city. My own constituency office in the Falls Road, 50% of the people who come in there are from the Shankill Road on a weekly basis, and that's on average. And I think that is a very positive step in the right direction. And that's us kind of to work with people from across all sections of community, bar none. And I think that we have done that in abundance. I don't believe other parties have done it in abundance. I think other parties always try to want to take it back into the past. We're a forward-looking party. I'm certainly a forward-looking person, and I want to make sure that my family, that their lives are better for the future, because I don't want to see my kids or anybody else's kids, for that matter, having to grow up in the society which I grew up in. You know, I had a number of friends who were killed. I had brothers and sisters who were arrested and put in jail. And so I don't want to see that happening anymore.
What would you say to those people who don't vote?
I think everybody should vote, no matter what party they choose to vote for. I think over the years, where especially in the north of Ireland, where there was gerrymandering and people didn't have a vote as well, I think it's very important, no matter what party you're going to vote for, that you should cast it. I think people waste an opportunity when they don't vote, because if they want to change whoever their politician is, then they need to vote for whoever the politician is they want to represent them.
With recent cuts to the arts sector by the executive, how can young people develop their skills and talents in music, art and drama, etc.?
I look at what Failure and Phobel does here in West Belfast. It has put thousands of people right across all their different events, and I've seen people who've started off in there as volunteers, going in there to work for Failure, are now employed in some are employed now even in the film industry, some are employed in the arts sector right across this world. So I see the importance of arts, because it gives people a really good footing to move to the future in a much more positive manner. And I think arts is absolutely first class for skilling people. It's first class for bringing people together. All sections of our community come together with regards to the arts. So I think it's a shame that there was cuts. I think it is a shame that £1.5 billion taken out of our budget here in the north of Ireland. And I think it's a shame then that that has to be imposed on some of the most marginalised people here in the north of Ireland, but also on some of the most disadvantaged communities in the north of Ireland. Some of them cuts are having a really massive impact on, and I think it's wrong. So I hope that whoever the change of government is in Britain, is that come after the 7th of May this year, is that they look to see the impacts that the cuts are making, and I hope that they can readdress that after the 7th of May, whoever the government is. And I think hope, again, is that the executive here can have additional resources put to it where that budget isn't cut. So it's unfortunate that has been the case.